Hey guys, welcome back to Office Hours with the Brofessor, the show where I say things. Got a cool show for you today. We're going to have Badass Historical Chinese Bros, Part 3, Guan Yu. So, the year is 189. The realm is in turmoil as the Han Dynasty collapses. Warlords rise and fall against a backdrop of chaos and intrigue. Out of the mayhem emerges one man mightier than all the rest. A hero in battle and a loyal friend in peace. This man's name is Guan Yu. Okay? He is the second of three sworn brothers. The oldest brother is the forgotten heir to the imperial throne. So against all odds, the three brothers do battle to restore the dynasty and unite all under heaven. Guan Yu has pledged his honor and his life to his big brother's cause. As both a friend and a warrior, Guan Yu was without peer. Before we get into Guan Yu's accomplishments, let's first get a feel for what this dude looked like, because he looked like an absolute boss. So, according to Romance of the Three Kingdoms, which, despite the name, is not actually a love story, Guan Yu was 9 feet tall. Okay? Dude was 9 feet tall, and he had a face that was red like a juju. Alright? So, red face. So he was 9 feet tall, he had this super red face, and he had these really thick eyebrows that looked, according to the book, like nesting silkworms. And he had this 3 foot long beard that he would like to stroke. So let's see, eyebrows and beard. So, his beard was, in fact, so impressive that he even came to be known as the Lord of the Magnificent Beard, which is a pretty cool title. So, in battle, Guan Yu was no less a badass. He wielded this long spear called the Green Dragon Crescent Blade, which is perhaps the most video game-esque name ever given to an item that was not actually in a video game. It was also called the Frostfair Blade, since when he fought in the snow, the blood of his enemies would freeze on the blade, forming a layer of frost. The weapon weighed like 100 pounds, I think like 50 kilograms, which I think is 100 pounds, but he could swing it around as if he was the 7th grade me in my backyard with a dowel rod. So anyway, I'm sure I'm not alone in that. Of course, actually, Guan Yu did not historically look like that or even do the things that he's best known for, but this is how we remember him. Right? So, in a way, I would argue that this legendary character of Guan Yu is, in its own way, quite real, and arguably even as real as the historical figure that no one really cares about, maybe even realer. So, Guan Yu may not actually have been, historically, a 9-foot-tall red dude with an unrealistically heavy spear, but he may as well have been. And besides, it's so badass that you can't You can't not think of him that way. So anyway, Guan Yu, or at least this legendary version of him, is my hero because, first and foremost, he was a good friend. He never betrayed his two brothers, no matter what was offered to him. One time there was this rival warlord, okay, and he wanted Guan Yu to defect to his side, so he gave Guan this super fast horse. It could go like hundreds of miles in a single day, and Guan Yu was like, oh cool, thanks, now I can go home and see my bros. So it was pretty much the complete opposite of what the warlord wanted. There was only one problem. Guan Yu was deep behind enemy lines with 5 fortified passes between him and his bros. Did that stop him? Nope! Guan Yu wrecked some fools in each pass that he came to. Absolutely murked some fools. He didn't even slow down when there was this one dude and he shot him with an arrow. Alright? Like this dude straight up shot Guan Yu with a bow and arrow. But he didn't even slow down because he wanted to see his bros that badly. Such was this guy's loyalty to his friends, okay? So another time, Guan Yu was fighting a battle and he got a poisoned wound, I think in his arm, okay? And the poison seeped its way through and worked into the bone so that it would have to be scraped out surgically. Alright, so when he got the news, Guan Yu was in the middle of drinking with his homeboys and playing Go, right? And it was a really good Go game, so he didn't feel like stopping for something stupid like life-saving surgery. So he did this. He said, okay, doc, just go ahead and do it right here, right now. Alright, and so the doc went ahead and just did it then and there, and he was awake the whole time. He was talking and drinking and playing Go the whole time. The dude didn't even flinch. Awesome. So anyway, for this kind of stuff, Guan Yu, for these exploits, Guan Yu has gone down in history for his steadfast loyalty and for being a tough as nails son bitch that didn't screw around and took the bro code seriously. It is for these qualities that he is my third Daka. Or remember in Chinese, that's Big Brother. The world would be a better place, in my opinion, if we all learned from his example. Okay? So that's my big bro Guan Yu. Up next, badass historical Chinese bros, part 4, Sun Yat-sen. See you next time.